Hello, today we're going to look into the error which has given me a lot of problems when I was starting NetBeans. I started NetBeans, but I'm going to show you what happened. Then I'm going to show you the quickest error and what's the cause of the problem. So I'm using Ubuntu and let me show you something which is going on here. We can go to settings, and one thing I want to be sure of, you will know what I'm using here. I'm using Ubuntu 20.0.4 LTE 0.1. So now the error, I find it there. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to what they call NetBeans. So I get this NetBeans. The NetBeans I'm using is 10.0. NetBeans 10. So now I did create a project, but I'm gonna create one. I'm gonna create a project called this is a Java project. I'm gonna go next. The way you create your normal Java project, I'm gonna say my error project. Okay, then say finish. After finishing the project, you know it has a main class already, but it shows this. You get me? It shows this error. So now I'm gonna go and say system dot out dot print, and I'm gonna put a string, and I say print me. Okay, this should be capital S. Okay, now when I try to run this file, it will never run because your no matching class found. So now I read on one of the articles, and I'm gonna show you this. One of the prompts is you can go to your folder, then you go to computer, then you go to USR, then you go to libraries, then you look for JVM. Please look for JVM. Where's Mr. JVM? Here we go. Then you can see that there's NetBeans, Java NetBeans. JDK is 11. This is the JDK it uses. It uses 11 Open JDK. Okay, so remember, it is said that NetBeans itself, it must use at least JDK 7 and 8, or JDK 10, because it's 10. So now let's close here. I'm gonna show something like went to tools. Let me see something. Platforms, you can see the link to the JDK. It's using JDK 11. But the guys, my own advice, don't stress yourself with this. All of this, you're gonna get into many things and you waste a lot of time. You get me? What I did was super simple. Let me show you something. Discard, save all, whatever. You can save all if you want. The best way do this, go to your software in Ubuntu, then you look for installed, look for install. I did install this solved my problems. So go to let me see if I uninstall. I'm gonna show you one of the NetBeans. The NetBeans are put in. I should take it out. So go and look for what they call. You can go to search somewhere, and you see explore. Then you look for Apache NetBeans. Apache NetBeans. Apache. So look for Apache NetBeans, because it said NetBeans was handled to Apache. So once you look for that, install this. Once you install that, it's gonna automatically work with with your JDK 11. You get me? So that's what I did. So I'm gonna show you what I did that it worked. So I even left that NetBeans, another NetBeans on that, so it works. So when you click here, you're gonna see NetBeans. This is the NetBeans I'm using, and also this one is Apache NetBeans. So they say the project was handled to Apache, so the one that you install for Apache is gonna work without giving you stress, because it's gonna use this Apache 11.1. that's what I installed. But I don't know the time you're gonna be watching the video, it will be which one, but try to install Apache NetBeans, not NetBeans straight. So after that, you can create your folder, your file. I'm gonna say create new. I'm gonna say I select Java with Cradle. Okay, application. Then you say next. When you go to there, I'm gonna say next. So the app, you can browse or leave it the way it is. I'm gonna guess this one. I'm gonna call it fixed project. After saying fixed project, then I say next, finish. Once I finish that, you can see my main class doesn't have any problems. So I'm gonna write system .out.print. Okay, after doing that, then you can put any of your strings here inside, and you say must go well. Okay, after that, you can say, you can save your file and run this. So you can see that the project runs so well, and you can see it does not give me any problems. So you can see the results are here. So guys, that's what I do recommend. My project is running so well using Apache NetBeans, so IDE. So you can see how it looks like. So that's what it's gonna save you time. But if you don't feel like safe to do that, you better go and download what they call JDK 10 or JDK 8 or 7, then you change the path to your NetBeans. But to my own experience, you're gonna spend a lot of time, because those configurations, sometimes they don't come cheaper, they're gonna be a little bit difficult for you to get them right. So download up, because since they told you that Apache was handled to NetBeans, NetBeans was handled to Apache, which means most all the new versions of NetBeans gonna come under Apache. So let me see Apache. NetBeans download. You can see there's NetBeans download here. Let's ask, was Apache, NetBeans was handled to Apache. Okay, let me see. Okay, NetBeans history, the Apache Software Foundation. Okay, what is the Apache NetBeans include incubating? Okay, Apache NetBeans, you can see this September 2020. You can see that the Apache NetBeans is pleased to announce that Apache NetBeans 12.1 was released on September 1st, 2020, and Apache NetBeans is a full IDE for Java Standard Edition, Java Enterprise Edition, PHP, JavaScript, HTML, and more, including some support for Groovy and new C plus, stroke C plus plus. You can see this is the best project to use now. And also, you saw that Apache NetBeans I'm using, it's the latest one. So to avoid any of these problems, to do get your things right, please do not get into involved into fixing that, what they call the JDK. Don't do that. Just download NetBeans Apache. It can work while you also, if you wanna challenge yourself, it can work with your another NetBeans when it's there. Don't worry, don't uninstall that. Install Apache NetBeans. It's gonna work, though that one is there, the one which is faulty. If you wanna fix that, you can get your spare time, then you fix it. But to do things easier, just install Apache NetBeans 12.1. is gonna fix everything. So because it works hand in hand with JDK 11, so your issue here is the JDK 11. So guys, I hope this video helps. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.